Her sets, Coco Gauff to serve. Playing. Oh!
And that's one big change in Sabalenka's game there has been the return position that she uses, and especially on the second serve. She's standing much farther back than she used to stand. Gives herself a little bit more time.
More in the wallop position. I guess Sabalenka is going after the golf forehand. She's made that intention clear already.
Yeah, and sending a message early that sometimes you do that to get in a player's mind, that I am going to go there and you're going to beat me with your least favorite shot out on court. That's a side that has stabilized a bit for Gauff in her great runs this summer.
17-1 is Coco Gauff since she lost so early at Wimbledon. She's going to be fighting off an awful lot of firepower today, isn't she? What Gauff can do. Chase down winners.
Sabalenka let her off the hook here a bit, Mary. Didn't get that hard enough or deep enough. And as you mentioned, any ball that she can get a racket on, she is going to get there. Is to go heavy and hard to the Gauff forehand on any kind of rally shot. And then when she's got some time, pick your side. 15-9. You think it rattles Coco how many forehands?
You bet.
She's seeing so early.
How is she going to get Sabalenka to lay off that wing?
Hasn't been an issue for Sabalenka through her first six matches, Mayor. In fact, these two players tied with total double faults at 21. And in that long semifinal victory against Keys, only four.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Serve held up at the most crucial times for Sabalenka.
She went big. She just kept going big, trusting her second serve, didn't she? Keep in mind, it wasn't that long ago that Sabalenka had lost so much confidence in her serve that she was hitting him underhand.
The funny thing about that was she actually didn't know how to hit an underhand serve. I'd actually never seen a player start with a topspin feed for the serve. Normally underhand, you're under slicing it. A big game here for Gauff. Try and settle down. Zero winners so far.
Coco's dad up in one of the fancy pants suites instead of down on the court. He's been there all fortnight.
At some point in this summer run, he wasn't there, and all of a sudden Coco, I don't want to change things. Dad has been here watching every match, but not sitting courtside where we have seen him the last 4 or 5 years of Coco's career.
First winner of this game. It's Coco's bomb behind the coaches. Sabalenka helped Coco hold it in that game. 2-1, opening set. missing, isn't she?
She's missing her forehand cross. That is the side that she comes up and out of. That one didn't miss by much.
Six errors now for the Belarusian. She's already been to the semis of the Open twice. She lost to Iga at the Open last year. And the year before that, she lost to Leila Fernandez, who ended up losing to Emma Raducanu, another teenager who's taken this title. That's well done. And this is, you know, Coco says her favorite surface is clay. So you wonder, all right, what's it going to be? You don't have to wonder with Sabalenka what her favorite surface is. She's won 13 titles, 11 of them, including the Australian Open, have come on this stuff.
Wow. There, she's hit 4 second serves 15. In this match so far, has missed 3 of them. One thing you never know with a player who historically has struggled with a shot. When do the demons come back? They're hitting her here early here.
Even at 2. And already the 24,000 inside of Ash Stadium are lit.
2 games on.
Sabalenka broke herself there. 2 forehand unforced errors and 2 double faults.
Here's Maria Sharapova. She won this title. Wow, there's a whole bunch of celebrities here today.
Thank you.
Called Kidman.
Let for service.
It's like they're going to be playing each other's forehands.
Sabalenka up to 9 unforced errors. Merritt, we're at 2 all.
Another one misses.
13.
Tina Navratilova is in the house. Mentioned that in 2006, Martina and Bob Bryan won the mixed here. It was Martina's final Grand Slam match. Her 16th U.S. Open title, that came 29 years after her first.
Was she 50 or almost 50?
In age?
Yeah.
She's my age.
No, but when she won her last
when
major.
She was 50, yes.
Yeah, not right now.
Yeah, not right now.
When she won her last major.
Yeah, she
remarkable.
Sure was. She was a couple of weeks from it.
Yeah. Sabalenka can get it there and find that area of the court. Gauff struggling, handling pace on that forehand wing right now. That's the favorite serve of Gauff, that sliding serve away. Sets herself up for the easy second shot. And that's a mentality that Coco's coaches have given her coming into this match. Every point, hang in there. Sabalenka will come up with some great shots, but she can miss anything. And that wasn't even close.
She wasn't even looking at the ball.
Middle of the net on this volley. Got to still remember and force herself to be aggressive when she has a little bit of time.
She's got to know that Sabalenka can miss. Like many multimillionaires, she's powerful but eccentric. This opening set, two of them coming from Sabalenka.
Sabalenka leads by 3-2.
Ball deeper in the court. Got this, go.
You were talking, Lindsay, because you've been down on that court this week, how noisy it is. You really cannot hear your coach sometimes.
No, it was Madison Keys who did the opposite of what her fiance coach told her and said after. I had no idea what he was saying. Right there, you could hear Coco speak up to Brad Gilbert. I can't hear you. Mm. Told her to swing more aggressively and get the ball deeper.
Oh.
both these two mentally are fighting themselves right now. Sabalenka, anything short now, just doesn't believe in herself, and Coco right now struggling to believe on her forehand wing.
12th unforced error.
Oof. Pressure on the forehand wing. And averaging 76 miles an hour, averaging off of both wings, 12 miles an hour faster than Gauff on the forehand, 13 on the backhand. Now the challenge for Gauff is, how does she get out of that exchange?
Yeah.
Forehand either has got to hold up better, or she's got to change some patterns around. Watched a lot of Coco's matches over the years, and at times wondered why players were giving her equal time backhands to forehands. But I've never seen anyone go after it as relentlessly as Sabalenka has early in this match.
Measure of the match so far, hasn't it? What a forehand misses. A nice length on that shot from Gauff. Just what her coaches want.
40.
Chance for another break.
It's one of the best midcourt forehands Sabalenka has hit, Mayor. She's missed an awful lot of those, but if she's going to win this match, she has got to figure out this area of the court. Coco's shots are landing short. She's not swinging through them. Again, averaging 63 and 64 miles per hour off the ground. It's sitting there for Sabalenka. Sabalenka scared to come in now, backpedaling on these midcourt shots, and Coco Gauff has earned herself another break point here.
Ah!
That's too good. Sabalenka's going to come up with a couple of those on big points.
And Lindsay, she's not going to back down from her power? She's
Not sure she knows how to.
Okay.
The bigger the point, the bigger Sabalenka goes.
She's happy she finally got the win at the net. How hard is it going to be for Coco Gauff if she tries to leg out these rallies?
That's why she's got to look to impose herself just a little bit.
Sabalenka gets out of trouble.
Sabalenka is one for game two.
First double fault for Gauff. First ace for Gauff.
But we hadn't seen the whole tournament from Gauff.
A just with the feet.
Somebody could really break down the forehand side.
It has been rock solid. through this tournament and really from the majority of the summer. Didn't know what was going to happen here. The double faults, would that hold up for Sabalenka? Would the forehand hold up for Gauff? Not so far.
Another break for Sabalenka. 5-2 for her, serving.
Sabalenka leads by 5-2, first set.
Aryna Sabalenka serving with new balls and serving for the opening set. Yeah, look at those numbers, just what you were talking about. It's not like Sabalenka's playing cleanly.
13-0.
It's her second ace. She colors with fat crayons. Know what I mean?
No, I don't.
It's big, fat. I mean, sometimes she's way outside the lines.
Okay, yeah.
Sometimes she's not.
The first six games went to deuce with both players having game points and Sabalenka able to win all three of those. Mm. So in those, the couple of big points and the big games that we've had in their first set, they all went to Sabalenka.
This gives Sabalenka two set points.
That forehand mare had a little bit more stick behind it. Gauff accelerating through it, trying to hit through the court.
There it is. The first set goes to Aryna Sabalenka.
Take your seats quickly, please. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Second set. Gauff to serve.
Coco Gauff starts set two.
Oh.
72-mile-an-hour serve. That's what she does to it. Just puts the thump on it. Puts a thump on everything.
Okay, Mayor, how does Gauff play more points like that? One of the first points we've seen Sabalenka stretch be on the run. Stretch, reach.
How does Gauff get ahead of the point?
Yep. That's her challenge right now. That's her goal.
Goal.
Oh, man.
15-14.
Just has not gotten to the final playing like this. Such an uncertain display.
This game. She'll have the crowd back in it.
First game, second set.
Dragged off the court. Plenty of open water for Sabalenka to finish that off.
Oh.
Tickle, tickle, tickle.
Move to her to the forehand. Come on, here we go. Come on.
Flies. 1-1 in the second.
Let's go, Cole.
Now, Coco had told her team before the last point to stop.
Yes.
So much info coming to her. Swing through on the forehand, get it deeper, move her out to the forehand, and finally she just said, please stop.
Please stop.
She's trying to figure out this final in real time.
Her fourth double fault, Coco's. It almost feels like different weight division-y, you know? The heavyweight Sabalenka against the middleweight.
What does Coco do best? A serve, a backhand, and the speed.
Okay.
Serve hasn't been a huge factor. Winning 54% of her first serve points. That has gone way up in the second set. That's 5-for-5 now. That's what one step to getting back into this match is to get that shot working. Only hit three winners so far. Has to figure out a way to move Sabalenka around.
Second ace.
40-15.
And she sure seems to want to try to figure it out by herself. Gotta like that. Coco has broken Sabalenka once. Sabalenka's broken her three times.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Sit down, please, now. Thank you.
Got to it. Gauff trying to spread the court on Sabalenka.
And Mare will take it. Look at where Sabalenka was on the side of the court. Just didn't get that drop shot short enough or low enough. At least she got Sabalenka moving a little bit at that point.
Got her. How they want to see more of this inside Ash Stadium. And imagine if she could break Sabalenka here, maybe some important emotional ice would be broken.
USOpen.org,
remember, across all those social platforms. I hope you find out just everything that's been going on during this fortnight. Women's championship right here, right now. Men's championship, Djokovic against Medvedev. Tomorrow afternoon, here inside of Ash. Thank you.
La 15.
Now Sabalenka actually taking a little bit off those shots, Mare, trying to just get them in, find her rhythm again. Gauff had the upper hand in that rally, the forehand letting her down there.
That's when Sabalenka knew she had a chance to win this one. That net court helped her. She recovered quickly. American champion 20 years ago. Last time an American took this title, Andy Roddick.
Thank you.
You know, that's one thing Sabalenka talked about after the last match was having to let the emotions out.
And she has.
Yeah, and right there, she let out a loud scream.
Some nutty errors from Sabalenka. Gauff now with a chance to go 4-1.
Let for service.
Coco Gauff stretches her lead in the second. See the power of Aryna Sabalenka on great display today. She's hit 10 winners. She's also struck 25 unforced errors. And that's what's keeping Gauff alive, very much so, in this championship match. Another one.
Love.
That's better play, and that's what you never know with Sabalenka, Mara. Sometimes one point can kind of change things. And that's why you don't want to be too passive if you're Gauff.
Yeah.
Because if she starts to find her range, there's one point against Keys. Yeah. Sabalenka won something like, she won 12 in a row at one point and 13 of 16. And
you can't give her the short stuff.
Given where the score is now, anything short, she's going to start swinging at again. She lost her confidence in that mid-range of the court, but Sabalenka now feeling like, well, I have nothing to lose. Don't want to give her too many, because then she actually might find that rhythm and get the confidence back. Or not.
That's good. So is that. That's even better. Wow. You got to give it up for Sabalenka, even if you're cheering for Coco in the stands.
14, and this place 15. Was about to explode. Everyone started to get off their seats, started murmuring.
Yep.
And then this one. How did she make that?
Thank you.
Sabalenka's team telling her she can get out of this in straight sets, aren't they?
A little more direct.
Yeah, very much so.
Their advice.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Fifth double fault for Coco Gauff. Those errors. When Sabalenka's bruising game lacks containment, Coco's got to take advantage. No double faults, no short stuff.
Oh.
Say 15.
Come on. Keep flying around the
court now. Be physical now. Come on, here we go. Be physical.
Some hold. Aryna Sabalenka, the world's new number one. After Iga Swiatek had held that spot for 75 straight weeks, Iga lost. Surprising early to Ostapenko.
15
in the quarterfinals easily. In the round of 16, I should say. 6-1 in the third.
Last couple of points decided on winners. And there have been 10 baseline winners for Sabalenka and just 4 off the ground for Coco. That's the way from Gauff. Mayer starting to accelerate a little bit more on that forehand.
40-30.
Monica Seles behind Tracy Austin.
Hey.
Okay, Mary, let's see how many returns Sabalenka can put in play here. Gauff going to have a chance to serve for this second set with new balls.
5-3, second set.
She's fighting so hard. And now she gets a chance to serve out this second set.
And Mary, she's finally playing the tennis she wanted to play
14,
in this final.
15.
Starting to play more free, starting to dictate play a little bit more. And really starting to get under the skin of Sabalenka.
Thank you.
Let's see if this thing goes the distance. Quick bathroom break for Coco.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Final set, Sabalenka to serve.
First game of the opening, the third set, the final set going to Aryna Sabalenka. Coco Gauff can get back shots that nobody Sabalenka has faced, has gotten back.
Improvements in her game in the last 12 to 18 months, started with the physical work and the technical work on the serve, Mayor, but
yes.
Huge transformation also on the emotional and mental side for Sabalenka. Be a real test today, though, if she's going to win this third set. I feel like Sabalenka's team has got to help her out, giving her some kind of buzzwords on that forehand. Something that they work on the practice court, just to settle her down with that shot.
Doesn't Coco seem to have more energy now?
30-40.
She can't get that one. Boy, she's trying hard to keep those rallies alive, huh? Trying to chase them down.
How about that reaction? Gauff doesn't get this point. Knows she did everything in her power. Turns right back to her box and gives a fist pump.
Yes, exactly. tactic is out of necessity, not design, but she's moving well. She's reacting well. She's forcing Sabalenka to hit a couple of winners in those rallies. Sometimes Aryna Sabalenka misses.
Advantage Gauff.
Chance for Coco Gauff to take the lead in this championship match. The break. This place is going nuts.
First game.
Saw in the semifinal after she got broken that last game. She walked over to her camp and took a racket from her coach. Almost every player takes all the rackets they need with them on court. I think that might be a superstitious thing now. There's no sense for her coach to be holding a random racket in the stands.
Coco taking control of the court.
4-15.
The American.
Gauff leads by 2 games to love. Final set.
Thank you.
And Mary, do you remember at the beginning of the match where it was the Gauff forehand that was the shaky shot?
Yep.
Great job she did of turning that around. And now it's a Sabalenka forehand. String dampener went flying on Sabalenka. What a run for Gauff these last few games.
She can change rackets again.
Love 13.
She did this at Roland Garros, Mare, when she started collapsing in the semifinal. After every point was switching rackets, at a certain point, it's not the racket, right?
The tension problems aren't inside the racket.
Well, I mean,
it's the racketeer.
Yeah, you got to figure something out besides the racket, the body, the stroke.
15-13.
Didn't Sabalenka deconstruct her entire serve in the offseason? I mean, down to its very bottom. So much so, she got a kinesiologist, right? To make her balance on one leg, to get her balance back.
30, 40.
But that serve of her is under pressure again. This could be a 3-love lead in the third. First major today. Some differential, isn't it? The errors.
You gotta expect this if you're Gauff. Another run by Sabalenka here. She's going to be number one in the world tomorrow, and she's there for a reason.
That's her 20th winner, Linz. But she's had 38 unforced errors. I mean, that's almost 10 games of errors. Coco Gauff proving to her you can hit through me.
Also not getting caught up
30-0.
In the emotions of the match at all, Gauff. Just has kept that focused, determined look in her eyes the entire match.
It's so true, Linton. Never lost her poise. At least not yet. And it doesn't seem like she shall. Feels like she's controlling every impulse of this match.
Forty
Gauff.
Couple of aces, a winner there. It had been over half an hour since Sabalenka had held serve.
Final set.
Coco still leads 4-1. And the trainer has been called out. Sabalenka. Let's see what she needs.
Sabalenka would show any signs of fatigue after Thursday night's late night, early morning win over Keys. It was a physical battle. It was also an emotional battle for Sabalenka.
Oh.
You think today has been a hangover from the semi?
Started off okay, but just seems that tank's not quite full out here.
Hard to make Coco Gauff look less than fresh.
And quite the opposite, exactly. And on the other side of the court, Gauff, again, going about her business, staying very focused, moving exceptionally well. And how about solving the problem of her forehand? Remember what an issue that was in the first set?
Sabalenka. Holding and now breaking.
That's Sabalenka's first break since the first set. Sabalenka was able to break three times in that opening set.
15-30.
Game away from the U.S. Open title.
Gauff leads by 5-2. Final set. Thank you.
Coco Gauff, you've just won the U.S. Open.